League Golf Coaches Tip of the Month. And this month we're going to start to look at, with the iron, how to get that really good solid strike into impact. So what we're trying to do when we hit the iron shots is we're trying to get the ball and then the turf straight afterwards, okay? So we get that nice, what we call compression on the golf ball. There's a couple of key elements we have to do to really help that to happen. There's a couple of simple things you can do to help you get that compression like the pros do on the golf ball. First of all, at the setup position, and this is the important part, is one, you get the ball position correct. So for a mid-iron, so it's sandwiched to 7-iron, the ball is pretty much central in the stance, okay, so it's in the middle of my feet here. And then from here, the key part is I'm having the shaft just leaning slightly forward. You see the top of the grip is ever so slightly in front of the golf ball. And what that does is that ensures that as that happens, the shaft leads and the club head then is striking down into the golf ball. What we don't want to see to impact is the shaft getting behind here. Imagine the shaft going backwards and the club overtaking. So it would look like this with your hands. So you release the hands and the club head now you can see is in front of my club grip. So once I've got my club grip slightly in front, so pointing towards my inside of my left thigh here, that always stays in that position as a good guideline for you. So as even when you go into a more forward stance, like a 5-iron, the top of the grip is still pointed inside the left thigh, but in relation to where the ball position is, it's not as far forward, and that's more suited then to more of an upswing with the longer irons. So you're still creating a slight downstrike even with a 5 or 4-iron, but not as much as you would when you're hitting a 7-iron or a sand wedge. So, my ball position is central, my hands are slightly forward, so the top of the grip is leading, and what I'm going to try to feel into impact is I'm going to feel my left hand is still going to be leading into impact, okay? I don't want to feel my right hand flicking and trying to add loft, and you might get a lot of those thins or clunky shots. A lot of you that hit, maybe hit the ball very, very high, a lot of it will be due to the fact you may be releasing the right hand into impact and adding a bit of loft, letting the top of the grip get behind the golf club. So what I'm going to feel on these next few swings, I'm going to have a few little practice swings, I'm going to take it back and I'm going to feel as I start down, I'm still going to be turning my body, but I'm feeling the top of the grip staying ahead, so I'm feeling that position into impact there. And that, you can see I'm getting that nice down strike. So I'll demonstrate that to you face on. So from here, ball position in the centre, top of the grip pointed in towards the inside of my left thigh. And then from here, I'm going to feel my left hand leading into impact. The club head feels a fraction behind me. From there, now you see I struck down into the golf ball. You can hear the ball and turf. Gave me the nice compression and the ball flight, with a lovely flight on it. It didn't pop up in the air. So when you go to the practice area this week, remember a few points. Wherever the ball position is, the top of the grip points towards the inside of your left thigh, okay? Ball position for the different irons will vary, but mid-irons, pretty much sandwich a 7-iron in the middle. And then from there, when you go to swing, I want you to keep turning your body, but feel the top of the grip leading into impact, so you can create that compression of the golf ball, rather than this, the right hand releasing, and the top of the grip overtaking the bottom of the head. So use that, and I think you'll find a big improvement in your striking of the golf shot, pressure on the iron. Hope that helps you, and we'll see you for next month's tip.